am not afraid. Anywhere, fear I cannot know. Anywhere with Jesus I can safely go. Anywhere with Jesus I am not alone. Other friends may fail me, He is still my own. Though His hand may lead me over dreary ways, anywhere with Jesus is a house of grace. Anywhere, fear I cannot know. Anywhere with Jesus I can safely go. Anywhere with Jesus I can go to sleep. When the gloomy shadows round about me creep, knowing I shall wake and nevermore to roam, anywhere with Jesus will be home sweet home. Anywhere, fear I cannot know. Anywhere with Jesus I can safely.
Let's bow our head. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you this hour asking for your blessing and help us we gather together in your presence. We begin to thank you for all the blessings and the miracles that you've given throughout this week. We cannot comprehend the number of blessings you pour out on us from day to day. Among all of us we have, there's so many hurting and needy people. We lift them up to you and ask you for that you will bless them, help them, and heal them. Please continue to be with our friends and families. May you continue to strengthen our bodies and protect us from the virus that are circulating around today. We ask that your Holy Spirit will be at work, opening our ears to hear, our heart to receive your word. Also bless the speaker tonight as we deliver your message to us from heaven, and we may be transformed by it and apply it to our daily lives. Be with us always, O Lord. We humbly ask for your forgiveness for our sins, and may you give us a strength and grace to forgive those who have sins against us, just as you have forgiven us for our sins. May our word and thoughts will be acceptable to you, and thank you for always hearing and answering our prayers. In this way we pray, in your Son's holy name, Jesus. Amen.
World, the coldest heart, the deepest wound, the endless dark, the lonely ache, the burning tears, the bitter nights, the wasted years, life breaks and falls apart, but we know these are places where grace is soon to be so that never came, for every vow that someone broke, and every lie that gave up hope. We live in the shadow of the fall, but the cross says, just watch and see. It will not be. Just watch and see. It will not be
Hello, wonderful people of Vancouver, Canada. Oh, how I miss each and every one of you. And I wish that I could have spent my Sabbath with you there right now. But you know, our new normal right now is just talking to cell phones, talking to screen, talking to computers. But I believe that there is still so much more to be praising God and thanking God for. And especially right now is the start of another week. No, it's the end of another week. It's Sabbath. It is God's special day. It's God's holy day. And I'd like to greet each and every one of you. Happy, happy Sabbath and happy new year. Yes, friends. So before we could go on with our program, let us bow our heads once again for a word of prayer. Let us pray. Our great God, our dear loving heavenly Father, Lord, it is such a joy to be in your presence. Even though we are far from each other, and I know, dear Lord, that we are not far from your presence. And Lord, we praise you and we thank you that you have been so faithful to us throughout the year 2020, a challenging year, but a year that has brought us closer to you. So Lord, I ask in a very special way that tonight, may our thoughts be centered upon Jesus and Jesus alone. And Lord, I ask in a very special way as well that you please open our eyes, open our minds, and help us to see how you have gotten us through 2020. And Lord, please build our faith. And help us, Lord, to know that even though what is ahead is not quite certain, but we are certain that you are with us, that you have promised to never leave us nor forsake us. So, Lord, may you awaken our hearts tonight. Help us, Lord, to be grateful. Help us, dear Father, to give you praise and to give you thanks, for you deserve every praise and every thanksgiving. Lord, once again, thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity to start this Sabbath in your presence. Lord, I ask that you please hide me behind your cross, that I may not be seen, but Jesus and Jesus alone be seen, be heard, be lifted up and exalted. This, Lord, we pray in the loving name of your Son, Jesus. All your children say, amen. Friends, This is quite challenging right now, huh? Our new normal. We're not able to see one another. And I hope that I could greet and see your faces even just in the screen. But right now, all I could see is my face. And I'm trying not to look at my face. But God is good, friends. There are still a lot of things, as I have said from the very beginning, there are still a lot of things to be praising God and thanking God for. Would you say amen? Amen. Would you say a louder amen than that? Okay, friends. So this evening, I'd like to share something that's quite neglected. We are not focusing on this aspect of our lives, something that we take for granted. And that is about praises, giving thanks to the Lord. Yes, friends, I believe that as a human being, we are actually naturally ungrateful. Yes, friends, we complain more than we should be thanking God for. You believe so? Yes, friends, if that is your experience, don't say amen, but just humbly admit it. Yes, friends. And a lot of people are complaining of what happened in 2020. But I believe, friends, that there are a lot of things that have been so much of a benefit for us during 2020. Do you believe so? Yes, amen to that, friends. Amen to that. And I believe 2020 has been a beautiful turning point in our lives that we may not even realize it, that God was really trying to stop us on our tracks. The Lord wants us to have that reset, to push that reset button, that we may lean fully upon Him. And for that, I praise God. For that, I thank God. Because I know that 2020 is the year that God has never forgotten. Yes, friends, a lot of people will tell me, it's like 2020 is like a year that God turned His back from us. I don't believe that. People will say, it's like 2020 is like the year that God closed His ears to our prayers. Friends, it's actually the other way around. A lot of people were praying during 2020. And I believe that a lot of prayers were somehow turned around, not just praying for self, but praying for the will of God to be made known, or praying for the will of God to happen. Yes, friends. So there are just a lot of reasons to thank God and to praise God for, even in one of the most trying years of our lives. So friends, that is one thing that I'll be focusing on right now, tonight. The aspect of praising God. The aspect of thanking God. Why is it very important? So friends, this is not a full sermon, so I'll just pick up some of the quotes that really speaks to my heart here as I'm sharing with you, and a few testimonies in the process. So friends, this one quote from Testimony Treasures, Volume 3, page 30, paragraph 3, it says here, God desires His obedient children to claim His blessings and to come before Him with praise and thanksgiving. You see, God desires that we claim what? That we claim His blessings and then come before Him with what? With praise and thanksgiving. It says here, God is the fountain of life and power. He can make the wilderness a fruitful field, and the people that keep His commandments, for this is the glory of His name. Friends, 2020 has been like a wilderness, but this is something that I realize. The people who took God at His word, the people who are still grateful of what little things that they have received from God, friends, their ministry, their lives have become a fruitful field, even in the midst of pandemic. Because we serve a God who's powerful in this pandemic. Can you say amen again? Yes, friends. It says here, He has done for His chosen people that we should inspire every heart with thanksgiving. Do you believe so? Has God done so much in your life that should inspire thanksgiving? I believe, friends, there are a lot of reasons to thank God and to praise God for. And listen to this. It grieves Him that so little praise is offered. Whoa. Friends, it grieves the Lord that so little praise is offered. Friends, this is one thing that I see as a challenge as I lead out like prayer sessions. As you know, I've been leading out United Prayer. I've been leading out prayer conference. One thing that's quite challenging in the aspect of prayer is praise. And then I realized later on, why is it so difficult to praise God? We ran out of praises, but we don't run out of prayer requests. Have you noticed? Yes, friends. Praising and thanking God is actually different. Praising God is praising Him for who He is. And thanksgiving is thanking God for what He has done. Remember, friends, praise is for who God is. And thanks is for what He has done. And then it dawned on me, the reason why it's difficult for us to praise God is because we don't know much about Him. We don't know Him that much. And it's difficult to praise someone whom you do not know. And friends, you know what? This is one amazing thing, because the more you draw closer and closer to God, the more you experience the wonderful presence of God in your life, you begin to realize that there are so much to praise God and to thank God for. So don't lose hope if you are not some, if you are challenged when it comes to praising God. This means that you have a lot of God to discover of. Amen. You have a lot of opportunity to know Him, and He wants you to know Him deeper. Isn't it amazing? So let me continue on. It says here, oh, this is a beautiful thought. Again, let me read that thought. It grieves Him, it grieves God that so little praise is offered, and He desires to have a stronger expression from His people. Did you hear this? He desires to have a stronger expression from His people, showing that they now, that they know that they have reason for joy and gladness. Friends, come and look at what God has done in your life. God desires a stronger expression from us, a stronger thanksgiving from us. I remember one time I was watching this show in YouTube, and this group of people are giving like surprise gifts to individuals. And this was Christmas. And they were picking these individuals that they will be giving their gifts random. And the host of this show was knocking on the office. It's the lady was behind this cubicle, this glass. And she was sitting behind the desk, and the guy was trying to get her to stand up, but she was quite reluctant to stand up. And the host of this show is saying, we have some surprise for you. And the girl is not even quite interested. So she came, and somehow she received this box from them. And guess what? She did not even let the host come in the cubicle. She just went behind her desk, opened the box, and inside was $10,000. Friends, you would expect that this girl would jump up and down. But you know what? She was just there, sitting behind her desk. And she said, oh, wow, this is big. This amount. And she said, I don't know what to say. Friends, I would totally understand if she was speechless. But friends, she was expressionless. And when she said, I don't know what to say, and I was about to scream to her, like, say thank you, jump up and down, do backflips, do cartwheels. And I have not seen that expression, that strong expression of gratitude coming from her. And the next person that they gave the gift to almost had a similar reaction. Friends, I could not finish that 48 or 50 minute episode. After the second person or the third person that has given that no expression at all, I switch off YouTube. And I'm thinking, oh Lord, how ungrateful. And then I realize, I'm that person. I am that person, because what God has given us, what God has given me, is worth more than $10,000. Yes, friends, it's worth more than that. Just look back on 2020, how the Lord sustained you, how the Lord has lifted you up, how the Lord has inspired you. Friends, there are so much blessings in our lives that we need to praise God and thank God for, with a stronger expression from you. And friends, it says here, listen to this. If we keep the Lord ever before us, allowing our hearts to go out in thanksgiving and praise to Him, we shall have a continual freshness in our religious life. Did you hear this? If we continually praise and thank God, we will have that continual freshness in our religious life. Friends, isn't that beautiful? If you are lacking that freshness in your life, maybe, just maybe, you need to add more praise and thanksgiving in your habit. Can you say amen to that, friends? Yes, just imagine. This is a beautiful promise, friends, that you will have that continual freshness in your life. Even though you have not taken a shower, you'll still be fresh. But I suggest take a shower. Okay, so friends, listen to this. Our prayers will take the form of a conversation with God. And as we walk and as we talk with a friend, did you hear this? If you want to have a personal or close walk with God, one of the best ways to do it or to start it is to praise Him and thank Him continually. Let the words that come out of our mouth, we should be praying that it should always be praise and thanksgiving, even when difficult things are around us. And listen to this, friends. Our prayers will take the form of a conversation to God like we talk to a friend. And friends, come to think of it. When you receive something that's quite worthy of praise and thanksgiving, when you receive a beautiful, wonderful surprise, good news, great news, who do you run to talk to? You don't run to your enemies. You don't run to the people who are not close to you. You run to the closest person in your life and you share that with that person. And I realize, friends, we're not doing much of that with God. We only tell Him our troubles, but we do not tell Him about our joys. Friends, if God is really our best friend, then we should be telling Him about our praises, about our thanksgiving, about our surprises that He Himself knows, that He Himself has given you. But friends, get this. God desires to hear it straight from you. He wants you to treat Him as your best friend. And when good things happen in your life, run to Him. Don't tell Him only the bad things that happen. Tell Him about the great things because He wants to hear it straight from you. And listen to this, friends. As we converse with God with our praises and our thanksgiving, as we talk to Him as a friend, this will happen. He will speak His mysteries to us personally. Did you hear this? Friends, if we treat God as our best friend, He will tell us our secrets. Wow. Did you hear that? He will what? He will speak to us. He will speak His mysteries to us, to you and me personally. Often there will come to us a sweet, joyful sense of the presence of Christ. Friends, I believe that this is one thing that we lack right now. Instead of just telling God our complaints, instead of just telling God all the things that have bugged you down, all the things that have wearied you down, friends, thank Him. Praise Him for who He is. And I believe, friends, without a shadow of a doubt, that your perspective will begin to change and your life will begin to change. By the way, friends, that's found in Christ Object Lesson, page 129. And one thing that somehow really spoke to my heart is the story of Helen Keller. Friends, just imagine Helen Keller. She was born with sight. Yes, friends, she could see before she became blind. Just imagine how torturous that was. Being able to see, and that gift was taken from you. And she's deaf mute as well. Friends, one of the quotes that Helen Keller wrote really speaks volume. Listen to this. A blind deaf mute wrote this. So much is given to me that I have no time to complain or to ponder that which I do not have. Wow. So much is given to me that I have no time to ponder or to complain or to murmur of the things that I do not have. Friends, I believe you have more than what Helen Keller had in her life. And I believe that you have so much to thank God for what He has given to you. I'd like to share a wonderful testimony of what happened to the ministry that I'm working with right now. Yes, friends, I'm working with ASAP Ministries. For those of you who might be wondering what ASAP stands for, it's Advocates for the Southeast Asians and the Persecuted. This ministry is helping out ministries back in Southeast Asia, ministries that are having difficulty hiring missionaries or church planters or Bible workers or medical missionaries. So ASAP somehow stands in between these needs and ask God to move people's heart that they may be able to support these ministries who are in Asia. But friends, it grew bigger, and they're not covering Asia right now. So they are now covering the 1040 window. And just imagine, friends, there's a lot of needs. So every single day when we come together for worship, ASAP workers together with the leadership, we pray, we had devotionals. Every single morning, we had devotionals, 15-minute devotional and 15-minute prayer for all the needs that we have. And we do that as well. Three times a week, we have noontime prayer. Yes, friends, we gather together. We do united prayer for the missions, for the needs that are happening around us. And one particular day, that was 4 days before the year ended. So that was December 28th. Yeah, 28th. December 28th, the pastor who was leading the devotional, he forgot about the time. He ate the time and he somehow finished everything in less than 30 minutes. It was supposed to be a 15-minute devotional. But after that devotional, we didn't have time to have a group prayer. So he just prayed a closing prayer. And then before we somehow separated from one another, our assistant director gave us a report. And he said, "We are just so thankful for what God has done in this year, that even though businesses are closing down, even though the rate of unemployment were just rising up, but God has sustained the ministry. God has somehow provided so much more this year compared to last year." Friends, just imagine our Giving Tuesday scholarship fund like campaign. Like last year, we raised like 42,000. So this year, because we don't have that much faith, we set a 40,000 quota, a 40,000, what's this? Yeah, you know what I mean? Goal. Yes, a 40,000 goal. And friends, you know how much was raised this year, even in the midst of pandemic, despite and in spite of the circumstances that are happening around us? We raised $58,000. Isn't that amazing? God is just so good. So after hearing that, I was just like inspired. So I told the whole group, there were like 9 of us or 8 of us doing the devotional during the time. And I said, you know what? God deserves to be praised and thanked for what he has done. So they said, "Jem, why don't you lead out?" So I led out, friends. I lead out with this round of praise. And I said to them, even just one line of praises and thanksgiving, let's do it. God deserves it. So friends, we begin thanking God. And after that, friends, our spirits were just lifted up. I'm thinking, this is such an awesome time to be praising God and thanking God for seeing what he has done. So you know what I suggested? You know what? Let's end this year, these 3 days that are remaining. We have been asking God for the needs of his mission. And I believe that God loves this mission more than we do. So let us spend these last 3 days of our devotions in just praising him and thanking him and see what God will do. Friends, we did that. The next day, we just continued praising and thanking God. At the end of the day, we received news. The news came. Said people kept on knocking on the door. And they were just like dropping, one by one, dropping their donations. $100, $500, $300, $1,000. There was one donor who came bringing $5,000, friends. And what do you do when things like that continue to happen? We praise God. We thank God. the next day, friends, we continued doing it. Even in our midday prayer session, we praise God. Even though there was one time that there's just three of us during the midday united prayer, but we just praise God through the verses and Psalms, through the promises He has given in the Bible. At the end of the day, we received news that there was one person who gave $30,000. We were just blown away. And we received news from our director that while we were praising God and thanking God, one donor pledged to give $300,000 to $400,000. Our jaw just dropped to the ground. We're thinking, wow, this is what happens when you take God at His word. This is what happens when you see God as God. When you see God as a generous giver. When you see God as a powerful God. So what do? When things like that continue to happen, you continue praising God. So at that time, while we were doing the devotional, while we were hearing those powerful reports, I suggested to the group, hey, why not let's come together on the 31st? Remember, friends, December 31 is a national holiday, and we're not supposed to be in the office. And we're doing worship via Zoom anyway. So I told the group, why not let's gather together? God deserves the praise and thanksgiving. God deserves the praise and thanksgiving for what He has done. So friends, we even invited some of our co-workers who are on leave during the time. And so everyone was there. And before I started leading out, our director came in the picture and she began sharing. He said, by the way, Jen, before you start, I just want to give a report. Yesterday, or last night, one donor was moved by God to donate $30,000 every month for the whole year of 2021. Friends, that's $360,000. And then I was already tearing up. And she said this, but it's not over. She said the family that pledged to give $300,000 to $400,000, they promised they were moved to give $700,000. The moment she said that, I could not hold it. I just broke down. Friends, God is good. The Lord is somehow desiring to show us that He is God. But we do not, most of the time, we do not know Him. We do not praise Him more than we should. Friends, it was not over. Yes, it was not over. Last week, I was at Tennessee doing a week of prayer. And I received this news coming from the director. Jem, we received the $700,000 donation. And guess what? There was another $100,000 with it. It's all in all, $800,000 coming from just one donor. Friends, my mind was just like, I could not explain how amazing God is. And he said, Jem, and there's another person whom God moved to give $56,000. Friends, we serve an awesome God. We serve a powerful God. And the question is, are all the needs of ASAP projects met? No, of course, we have increasing need, friends. But we believe that even though our needs are more than what we have right now, or more than the pledges that came in, we believe that God will supply, because He showed us that He is God. He showed us at the end of the year that when we take Him at His word, that when we continue to praise Him, that when we continue to see Him as who He is, that He is God, then He will continue to show up. Friends, look back on what the Lord has done in 2020. There are so many reasons to praise God and thank God for. And start from there. Start from there and see what God will do. And see what God will do in your life. And you know what's amazing? It's not just you that will reap the benefits. It's the people whom you are associating with, that they will see that you serve a powerful God, that you serve a living God. And friends, it would be an awesome time to lead them to the God who has sustained you, to the God who has supplied all your needs, to the God who has given you life. Friends, before I end, I'd like to share this beautiful thought from the Last Day Events, page 72. This quote is quite familiar to each and every one of you, maybe to some. Remember God's past blessings. In reviewing our past history, having traveled over every step of advance to our present standing, I can say, praise God. As I see what the Lord has wrought, I am filled with astonishment and with confidence in Christ as leader. We have nothing to fear for the future, except as we shall forget the way the Lord has led us and His teachings in our past history. Friends, remember, we have nothing to fear for the future, except as we shall forget the way that the Lord has led us. Friends, it is only God has led us thus far. The reason why you are standing or you are where you're at right now, still alive, is because of God's leading. And I'd like to end with this last verse of this beautiful thought, a beautiful song. Remember how God has led us in the past? So our statement should be, lead on, O King Eternal. Listen, lead on, O King Eternal. We follow not with fears, for gladness breaks like morning wherever thy face appears. Thy cross is lifted over us. We journey in its light. The crown awaits the conquest. Lead on, O God of might. Friends, let's continue fixing our eyes upon the one who's leading us on. And you will never regret moving forward knowing that God is with you. And continue to praise His mighty and holy name. Let us bow our heads for a word of prayer. Our great God, our dear loving Heavenly Father, Lord, we just praise you and thank you for being such an amazing God. For being such a powerful God. A God who supplied all our needs. The God who has been faithful to us. The God who has sustained us throughout 2020. And the God who never left our side. Lord, we praise and we thank you that we have so much evidence of your faithfulness in our lives. So as we move forward, as we continue following your bidding upon us, help us, Lord, to look back on your faithfulness and not have fear. Lord, I know that there are some crazy things that are happening around us, but Lord, please help us to fix our eyes upon the one whose eyes is fixed on us. And Lord, please draw our heart closer to you. Help us, O Lord, to continually praise you and give you praise and give you thanks and trust you with all of our hearts. And Lord, we praise and we thank you that we have nothing to fear for the future, because what you have done for us and to us in the past, there are so many unlimited reasons, O Lord, to trust you. So Lord, I ask, speak to each and every heart, especially my heart, O Lord. And Lord, I pray that you please minister to each and every heart right now that's watching this, that's listening to this devotional. Lord, I pray that whatever it is that's bothering us, that's hindering us from giving our all to you, dear Father, I ask that you please give us the courage to lay it all at the foot of the cross. Please, Lord, anoint all of us with the anointing of your Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord, for showing us that we have nothing to be worried about in 2021, because the God that has been with us in 2020 is the God who's in front of us, who's leading us. So, dear Father, we pray, lead on, O King Eternal. We pray all this in the loving name of your Son, Jesus. All your children say, amen. Friends, God bless every one of you. I hope and I pray that I'll see you someday soon. Bye-bye and happy Sabbath.
Take care of you. Be
of toil when your heart that fail, God will take care of you. When dangers fears your path assail, God will take care of you. Take care.